Hi everyone, Said here. I hope you are doing great. In today's lesson, we are going to learn AutoFill, which is one of the best features in Excel. With the help of AutoFill, things are done much faster. So let's check out how to use it. I want to write the numbers 1 to 12 in these cells. I write 1. Did you see how much it takes to write these numbers? What if I want to write 1000 numbers? It would take forever. Let me first delete all these. In Excel, we have a feature which is called AutoFill. If I select a cell, do you see the dot in the corner of the cell? It is AutoFill handle. Let me tell you what it is doing. I write 1 and 2, then I select both cells and hover my mouse on the dot. When my mouse cursor shape changes to this, I drag it. Excel automatically writes from 1 to 12 in the cells. I can do it for 1000 number 2. Let me press Ctrl Z to undo that. Look at the screen. I can drag it wherever I want. See, I wrote almost 1000 numbers with only dragging and the help of AutoFill. I Ctrl Z to undo that. For me, 12 is enough, so I drag it till 12. You can do another job. If you have any data in the side columns, you can see that I have data in these cells. So I write 1 and 2 and select both of them. And this time, instead of dragging, I hover my mouse on the dot, and when my mouse cursor shape changes to plus, I double click on it. Excel automatically continues AutoFill based on the data in the side column. Let me undo that. For example, if I write Said in the cell and run the AutoFill again, you'll see that Excel continues the filling till the last data in the side column. Why did I write 2 in this cell? Why I didn't write 3 or 4 or 5? For example, I write 1 and 3 here. When I write 2, I am telling Excel to add number 1 to number 1 to get 2, and add number 1 to number 2 to get 3. In fact, I am setting the step value to the AutoFill. Look at here. I am telling Excel add number 2 to number 1 to get 3. The number 2 is my step value. If I run AutoFill, it will add number 2 to the above cell and writes it down to the below cell. For example, I write 10 and 20 in these cells. Can you tell me the results? It will add 10 to the next cell value. If you are lazy like me and you don't even want to write number 2 in the below cell, write number 1 in the cell and run AutoFill. You'll see that the number 1 has been copied to other cells. Click on the fill option icon and you can see some different options. Copy cells option copies the selected cells to other cells, but the fill series option set the number 1 as the step value. If you can't see the fill option icon, you have to activate it. Select the file tab and click on option. The Excel options window opens. Select the advanced options and scroll down a little bit, and in the cut, copy and paste section, check the show paste options button when content is pasted. For me, it was already checked. If it isn't checked for you, you have to check it and click on OK. You can even use AutoFill for the time too, but for writing the time inside the cell, you need to follow the writing format for the time. For example, I write 1 colon 30. It means 1:30 in the morning. If I select this cell, look at the formula bar. It is telling me that it is 1:30 a.m. Now I want to set the step value, so I write 2 colon 00, which means 2 a.m. So if I use AutoFill for these two cells, it will add time 30 minutes, 30 minutes. Do you see that? If in the first cell I write months and run AutoFill, it will copy the months in all the cells. But if I write months 1 and run AutoFill, it will add numbers step by step. If I click on fill options, you'll see that by default, fill series has been selected. If I select copy cells, it will copy the selected cell to other cells, but I want it to be like before, so I select fill series. Alright, I want to write January in this cell. If I run AutoFill, it writes all the months to the cells. If I write the abbreviation of it in this cell and run AutoFill, you'll see the abbreviation of the months. If I write Sunday in this cell and run the AutoFill, the days will appear in the cells. But what it is? Why Excel is sensitive to the days and months? You know, by default, days and months have been defined for Excel. And if you want to define a new list, you should follow these steps. For example, I use this list a lot in my Excel files. Morning. For adding this list in Excel's custom list, first select the file tab and click on options, then click on advanced and come down to the end. In the general section, click on edit custom list. Custom list window opens. Here you can see the Excel's default list. For adding a new list, select new list and click on this arrow icon. And then select your list, and now the list has been selected, so I click on this button to come back. Then click on import. Look, the list added. Now I click on OK to exit. Now if I write midnight and run AutoFill, what happens? The entire list is displayed. I have a challenge for you. I want you to change this list to this with the help of AutoFill. So pause the video and think about it. If you couldn't do that, it's okay. I will show you how to do that. But first, you need to think about it, at least for a minute. You can download the file in the description. Okay, let me show you how to do that. First, let me delete these cells. And I select these cells and change their color to blue. And now it is time to run AutoFill. So I select all of them and drag it to the bottom. Do you see that? Not only I can use AutoFill for data, but also I can use it for formatting too. If you click on fill options, if you select fill formatting only, AutoFill applies the format only. If you select fill without formatting, AutoFill applies only on the data and it won't bring any formatting with itself. But we want both of them, so I select fill series. There is no limitation for you. You can use AutoFill in any direction. You can go up, right, down, and left. Alright, it was the basic of AutoFill. In the advanced section, you are going to learn much more about it. In next lesson, you are going to learn how to use AutoFill for date. And I think in a few lessons ahead, you are going to learn how to use AutoFill in the formula. So stay tuned and I see you next lesson.